Well, arachnophobes beware. You may be seeing a massive new spider as big as your palm right in your own backyard. And joining us live to tell us more about the Juro spiders is Dr. Michael Raup from the University of Maryland. Great to see you as always.
Good morning, Jen. How are you? And I brought along one of my friends. You can see it. Now, this spider really isn't as big as my head. Juro spider is only going to be about as big as the palm of my hand. So it is one of two very large spiders that are in the South right now, but a very recent study has shown that the Juro spider, by virtue of a higher metabolism, faster heartbeat, ability to withstand chilly temperatures, hey, this spider may be escaping the South and heading up the Eastern Seaboard.
And like the Army, they're going to be parachuting from the sky, apparently. Is that right?
Oh my gosh, no. Remember Charlotte's Web and how her cute little spiderlings would balloon away? I'm not calling this parachuting. That sounds like some kind of invasion from Mars or something.
Right?
No, they balloon. So I'm calling this ballooning, not parachuting.
Oh, and I love the pretty little picture you're trying to paint for us. Just think of them as Charlotte's babies blowing our way. But the truth of the matter is, they're really not, they can't hurt us, right?
Yeah, the fangs are too puny. Basically, they're not going to be able to pierce our skin. These are very docile spiders. I visited with these spiders in the South in Costa Rica, and they're not interested in biting us. They're just going to build a big web like our yellow and black garden spider, which is already here. It's indigenous, and they're going to capture prey. The good news, Jen, is some of our invasive species, that brown marmorated stink bug, and the nefarious spotted lanternfly, hey, these spiders have an ancient association with those pests back in Asia. I think it's going to be kind of like Hannibal Lecter having an old friend over for dinner. So they may actually do some good once they arrive here in Maryland, which is still a ways off.
So with some milk and fava beans, they could be eating up the stink bugs for us, right?
I hope so. But remember, these guys have been in the South since 2013. So if you're expecting the Juro spider here in Baltimore in the DMV this spring, I think you're going to be disappointed. I'm guessing it's going to take many years for it to actually work its way up the coast, unless it gets a human assist hitchhiking in a, let's say, a recreational vehicle or something like that.
All right, and real quickly, there's some interesting folklore about these spiders. Is that right? Like they're shapeshifters or something like that?
They are. Juro gumo in Japan, the spider changes into a beautiful woman. She then lures the males in, seduces them, binds them with silk, and then she eats them. It sounds like a very bad date to me.
It sounds like a horrible date. Dr. Raup, thanks so much for joining us as always. Can't wait to talk more about those giant spiders when they actually do make their way up the East Coast. Thanks so much. Have a great rest of your
weekend.
Thanks
so much, Jen. Good to see you.